Everyone, it's Holly Rocks. It is time for your daily dose of TikTok. Daily dose. Awesome. Another fake disorder fucking video. I like this chick. She's a mental health worker. Yeah, that's what we do. After you have to be around crazy all day, you get off work and you start acting freaking crazy because that's all you can do. Yeah, you gotta let it go somehow. Yep, I like her.
Do you remember when older folks used to tell us that they were forced to switch writing hands from the left to right, and that if they didn't, they were punished? Well, we need to talk about that because it's extremely important. You see, the left hand connects to the right side of the brain.
Everybody's a scientist.
The right side is the more creative, the more intuitive, and the more emotionally driven. The left side is the analytical, the logical, the intellectual. So by forcing us to switch, we were made to be left brain people. And the problem with that is with intellectualism, you can make somebody believe anything, even if their intuition and their gut is telling them the opposite. That's why they tell you to remove emotions from the situation and to only move logically. But truth is, we are very emotional beings. The left brain is perfect if you want to make somebody just a robot. They even reinforce this by switching how we read.
Oh my God. No, it's not true. Shut up.
From the right to the left.
Oh my God. Clean your fucking room. I'm so depressed. I'm gonna film myself being depressed. This is fucked up. I didn't like. This is very sad. Her friend committed suicide. That is very fucking sad. This is not funny at all. And that's what pisses me off.
What are those numbers on your arm?
That's what pisses me the fuck off, is that there are people that are really suffering.
Knock, knock. Who's there?
Not your dad.
What? God damn, dude. Oh, God. Why does this make me so angry? See, like, this is sad.
Okay.
Yeah, I'll leave tomorrow.
That's so sad. This made me cry when I saw it.
Maybe.
Wow, so that's it, huh? Just 4 o'clock and you are gone for good.
Why am I so sad? Am I doing the wrong thing?
Absolutely.
That's so sad. Her mom committed suicide. That is like really, that's what I'm saying. There's, and then I wanted to add this in here. I remember making this video because I wanted to put this in here.
Issues, you know, that anything can happen. We had a client that comes into court once a month for the court date. And they used to always make a grand entrance. And, you know, we thought it was amusing, you know. So, you know, when we see that name on the calendar, we expect them to come in to see the grand entrance. So then one day we saw the name on the calendar, but she never came in. And then we come to find out that she committed suicide. So
sad.
My name is Kevin Carter. I'm a senior court officer. I've been working this part, I think, about over 5 years now. My sergeant, the illustrious Sergeant Jay Greenberg, reached out to me, and he asked me if I wanted to work in the park. They asked me because of my temperament. I grew up in Brooklyn. Yeah, I've seen people with mental health issues, some friends, some family members.
This guy is just amazing.
I'm not a therapist or anything like that, but you're going to look at everybody through like a therapeutic lens. You know that some people maybe experience like auditory hallucinations, you know, you couple that with substance abuse, you're already prepared to kind of like, you may just have to talk to them a little bit longer, not get too confrontational, but this time you may have to raise your voice a little bit. We have more empathy for people who have mental health issues. As soon as they make contact with us, they know that we're here to support them as far as graduating from their programs and just getting through it. We clap for them, like if they complete a stage or if they graduate. So you have the whole courtroom clapping.
That's awesome. That is so awesome.
You don't see that in other courtrooms.
You don't. You don't see that at all.
Once a month, they kind of get to know your name. You get to know their name. You know, some of them very talented. Sometimes the judge will stop proceedings and let them come up and do some poetry, or they'll maybe even sing for the courtroom. They feel like they're recognized. They feel like
they're
not like outcasts or anything like that. We all rooting for them.
Graduation day. Congratulations.
So then when it gets to graduation, the final
Not
step,
every city has this either, and they should.
Of them. You know, you get to see, like, the joy. Like, they just, you know, got their diploma. It definitely promotes public safety.
Like, they need this in New Orleans.
And they're getting a second chance. They spread the message to keep other people from doing wrong as well.
Yeah, I'm
proud
definitely.
To work in this sport. And whatever little part that I do to help somebody succeed, I'm proud of that, too.
You're an amazing man. You are freaking awesome, dude. Awesome. I love positive stuff like that. I do. I'm not laughing. I just was laughing at that meme that went through. Awesome. Here's my sorry about your face design. It's from my merch store. You guys definitely check out my links if you want to get some sorry about your face merch. This video is pretty deep. There wasn't a lot to rip apart. Because I want to add stuff that's real, and I want people to be able to see the difference between the reality of real mental health issues and then the difference when you're looking at TikTok or Instagram or Facebook or YouTube and you see people that are blatantly trying to be mentally ill for, fame, views, followers, clout, whatever, however you want to put it. It's not funny. I think it's ridiculous and stupid and sad, and it freaking pisses me off because I worked in mental health for over 16 years, and nobody wants to be sick. Nobody wants a genuine person that's seeking help does not wake up and go, God, I hope I get to go to the hospital today. God, I hope I get to let down all my family members, or I hope to embarrass everyone, or I hope to lose my job. Because those are the kind of things that happen. So, you know, just please share this video, you know, create awareness, support, you know, small YouTubers like me. I like to have fun. I want people to laugh. But I also want to, you know, every once in a while bring in something a little serious, you know, and just kind of try to use this platform for good as well, not just mindless entertainment that's going to eat your brain out. Okay, so thanks everybody. I appreciate you. Thanks again. Subscribe. It's free. Bye.